Hello. Welcome to Plus Quinma. This is Pokémon Taglocke. This here is Ben. He's our special guest.
I'm waving at the camera.
Okay. Just as a quick recap, we ended with getting the first badge. The party consists of a Chespin named after Fire Emblem. Yes, we have a bleh. An Azurill named after Fatal Frame. A Litleo named after Lion King. A Ralts named after Dragon Ball. A Spewpa that's ready to evolve named after Kilala Princess. And a Pidgey named after Danganronpa.
Wait, what? Hina?
Yeah.
Oh, I get it, as in Hajime Hinata. Took me a second.
Oh, actually, that's in Oe as a Hina. Because in the English dub of the game.
Hey, me. I was, let's call it 50%, because the name is 50% there.
Okay.
Anyway.
Oh, yeah, there's another Danganronpa in there.
So, just to be clear about this, the PC box is, this box is currently, being used as storage and not as, dead, right?
That's correct. Oh, and you're doing Nuzz, right? Not Wonder?
I was planning to do Nuzz, especially since we can't connect to Wonder Trade anyway.
Oh, yeah. Well, I would have done it off-screen, I guess, or at home. I don't know.
Hey, I don't have tethering. Don't worry about it. Alright, this seems pretty straightforward. Oh, cool. Teleport.
Useful for caves. Trunks is caught literally right before the end. Oh yeah, I almost forgot. Andrew told me to tell whoever's playing to use a status curing thing to thank him.
A status curing thing?
Like antidote or burn heal.
To bank them or thank him?
Thank him.
Alright.
So.
Whew, it's been a while since I played X and Y. Nice.
Are you getting Sun and Moon or?
I'm trying to decide. At this rate, I might have to end up getting Sun and Moon.
Alright.
So, I take it that this left off here, yes?
Yes.
And we have...
You can catch three Pokemon. Your rules for catching Pokemon, whatever you want it to be.
I'll just do standard Nuzlocke with repeats cut out, so.
Okay. I don't know how many Pokeballs we have.
11.
Okay. I had, in the woods, I was doing standard catch as well. And I was so upset when I ran into a Pikachu. Because I was just like, no! As much as I love Scatterbug, I want Pikachu.
More like Pikachu, am I right? Sorry.
Pikachu! Nothing wrong with Ladybug.
Do we have one of these already? We do not. Alright, so...
I'm so excited for Spewpa to evolve.
It seems pretty spoopy. No way. Well,
I've never raised a Scatterbug, so I don't know what type of Vivillon Canada gets.
It's actually different by province. Here in we get sort of a brownish pattern. It's called High Meadow or something.
Hmm.
not brownish, more tannish. I'm sure you'll see it on this video sooner or later.
Alright. I do remember that the touchscreen isn't mandatory, right?
I just like using the touchscreen.
Alright,
because... That was a hint to use the buttons, wasn't it?
No, I was just wondering if I should just cut and get out the stylus.
Oh, I actually have a stylus. For y'all watching at home, stylus power. Oh, right, now I have to name this. This is what happened when your mind goes blank, folks.
Why, what are you naming? Ladybug. What's its name? Is that what it says?
What's his name has been transferred to box one.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which is in the name? I know that's like a Shakespeare thing from somewhere.
I know a rose by any other name would something, but that's like...
Seems like this player, or this protagonist, likes to just skate in a circle.
Yeah.
And according to Andrew, he also likes breaking into houses.
Well, that's just a given.
Yay. Are you looking at what's his name stats or something?
Yes. Tackle and supersonic. I'll just... This has ember? Okay, I'm just gonna swap out temporarily so that this can grow stronger.
Okay.
Wait, we haven't received the...
No, we have the experience share. It's just turned off right now.
Okay. Normally, for a Nuzlocke run, I'd leave the experience share turned off, but since I only have an hour with this, I want to get rid of the count.
Mm.
Also, I can actually do this. The circle pad on my own 3DS is all beat up.
Oh. Does it come from skating in a circle?
No, actually. It comes from downloading Super Smash Bros. And then...
Mm.
Yeah.
Well, I have it for Wii U, not 3DS.
Oh, right. I remember this. Kind of. Another Flabebe.
Oh, so I was watching a Nuzlocke yesterday, and it was terrifying and hilarious at the same time. Because the people playing, it was a versus one. And they both almost lost to Karina's Lucario.
Oh, that thing. Yeah, all you can really do is,
I think they were both left with two Pokemon at the end of that battle.
Yeah, they pretty much set up that battle so that the only way you can do it is to Mega Evolve your Mega Lucario.
Oh, it's not that one. It's the one where you're leaving,
that one.
Yeah.
Ugh.
Yay! Finally, the bug is up there! And then accidentally press B.
See? Sort of brownish.
Mm.
It's called High Plains or something like that. Fivillon is awesome. Oh man, when you get Fivillon up to a late level, it learns up this exclusive move called...
Powder.
Oh yeah, you heard about it? It's great!
I didn't just hear about it. When I played this game the first time, I had a Pansier and went up against it like Viola's Vivillon. It used powder on me, and I didn't know what was going on because this is like the first time playing it. I was just like, what? That was not a fun intro.
Yeah. I wonder if they'll make it not Mon exclusive in Sun and Moon. That might be interesting.
Who can you think of who would be able to use that move? Like Butterfree or any of the new ones? Cutie Fly?
Any sort of grass or bug type Pokemon, you know, I don't know, Breloom, any bug grass, I don't know. Trainers! Roller Skeeter Cicada.
That is a very odd name to give someone.
Wait, Kalida. That's still an odd name.
Cicada Frame Azurill.
Yeah, Fletchling doesn't get its fire type until later.
Yeah, when it becomes Fletchlander, right?
Yeah. I got tired of when I had a Fletchlander in my X and Y. I was like, when is this thing gonna evolve? And finally, oh, to heck with it. I'm just gonna... Oh my gosh, someone's seen The Lion King 2.
Well, yeah, it's like the best Disney sequel ever. Yeah. Andrew is the one who named that. I can see it. It really is the best. Do you have a favorite Disney sequel or just Lion King 2?
I haven't seen many Disney sequels.
As long as it's not Pocahontas 2, then it's fine. It's probably one of the only movies that I've ever watched and actually had to stop partway through, eject the thing, and then just never watched it again.
Wait, why is it that bad?
Because it completely destroys Pocahontas' character. She wears the necklace in honor of her mom, she takes the necklace off and puts on a European dress, and it's just like, what? Why would... No. It's supposed to be more historically accurate, but...
How do you... Okay, there we go.
Yeah, it's supposed to be more historically accurate, but that doesn't mean that that's the type of movie that people want to see.
Hmm. Fun fact for Nuzlocking. They rigged it so that the first Pokemon you encounter in on Route 1 will always be a... Sorry, Route 2 will always be a Pidgey when you start a new game.
Only in this one or another?
In X and Y.
Huh. I didn't know that.
Yeah, I mean, apparently it's caused some schisms, like, about whether you can... whether you can skip the Pidgey or catch it if you're, you know.
Actually, are you sure that's true? Because in the Nuzlocke I'm watching, one person got a Fletchling first.
Wait, really?
Yeah.
Huh. Maybe it's not... Uh-oh.
I mean, the other person got Pidgey, but one of them got Fletchling, so...
By the way, what audience are we aiming for with this Taglocke?
Anyone who will bother to watch. Most likely the people who are in it.
Okay, in that case I don't have to worry much.
Whoever is at the controller, I feel like they're the ones who should be making their own rules.
It's mostly because if I ever lose a Pokemon, I'm likely to break out in a torrent of swearing. So I figured I'd get that sorted out well in advance.
Oh, that's fine. I mean, I can always bleep things.
Actually,
if it gets really bad, I can.
Okay, I mean,
But yeah, feel free to swear
to quote the game Brutal Legend. It's funnier if it's bleeped out.
Yeah.
I should be using teleport.
I bleeped out some words that both Andrew and I said last time. And they weren't even swears. They were just words that we don't use in Canada. So it's just like...
What, like... You're gonna bleep that out, aren't you? Right, now if I remember properly, in before... Oh right, there's like a... honey in that bush.
Oh, well that's convenient.
And, time for some light grinding.
Alright.
Supposedly you can find Dunsparce along Route 3.
Oh, yeah.
On like a 1% chance or something. I found one, but I couldn't catch it. And then I tried to catch it, you know, later, but I couldn't find another one.
Yeah, when I was, doing my off-screen grinding montage to, what song? Sonic Boom song.
Supersonic?
No, it was a fan song. A fan song, that they made before the Sonic Boom came out, because they were excited for Sonic Boom.
Speaking of which, what do you think? Do you think Sonic Boom Fire and Ice will be any good?
I'm hoping that it is. I mean, it's supposed to be more speedy and more based on the DS one that did better, so...
Yeah.
All one can hope is that it's going to be good. One I'm looking forward to is Sonic 2017.
Honestly, the Sonic team has had enough bad breaks that they deserve to make a really smash hit for once.
That's why this time Sega isn't forcing them to get it out this year.
That's why they... Okay, now I'm kind of wishing I had Pidgey. I'm gonna teleport back and swap.
Okay.
We've got a fully evolved bug we can swap out.
Off-screen, I did some grinding, and I ran into two Dunsparce and a Farfetch'd.
What? That sounds pretty far-fetched.
It's true! And I was just like, I can't catch him.
Oh, he's got rollout. Never mind. Okay, we got... Oh, by the way, you know Sina and Dexio from,
Yeah, they're in Sun and Moon now, right?
As tourists! I can't believe it! Dexio's got that stupid Hawaiian shirt on! It's great!
Oh, I forget who said it, but apparently when you go traveling... You cannot wear a stereotypical Hawaiian shirt or else people know you're a tourist and they're more likely to pickpocket you because they assume you have money.
I believe it. In like the game NetHack, if you're wearing a Hawaiian shirt and a shopkeeper sees it, the prices will automatically go up about 300%.
Stereotypes.
Okay. Wait, isn't the next route after this... Oh boy, this is... Oh, we get our gift Pokemon!
Yeah. Are you going to want to consider your gift Pokemon as one of your three, or separate from those from your three captured?
Probably separate, but okay. I'm going to try and pick one that has good synergy for the team anyway.
Alright.
Honestly, we've got a strong grass type, or we will. and we've got a strong, and I've had my fill of Venusaur by playing him in competitive, and we've got a strong fire type, or we will. So I'm totally going with Bulbasaur. Bulbasoops.
Alright.
Bulbasooples. No, wait, that Blastoise.
Blastoise is good too?
Well, I remember this Burmy, the one that protects all the time and you can't get the hit on.
Well, it didn't protect then.
Oh, this one actually knows Tackle. But...
there it goes.
Yeah, it's like every Burmy grows knowing Protect. It's really annoying, actually.
I forget, which Pokemon I traded off. As a kid, I saw the Pokemon Mock'em and I really wanted it, but I couldn't find Burmy anywhere. So I convinced my friend to trade me a male Burmy for this Pokemon that was a Pearl exclusive. He gave me a female Burmy. And I was just like, this isn't what I wanted!
Make the best Steel-type Wormadam that the world has ever seen, is my advice.
That's the one I did. This is like back when Pearl first came out.
Speaking of Sun and Moon, I am obliged to bring up the following.
Okay.
Exeggutor.
I'm used to it now.
I know, but it's just so... I love it! I want one!
What I feel about Alolan forms is that as long as the Pokemon I transfer over there don't change into a Alola form, then I am 100% fine.
No, transfers are... it's when it thing.
When you only capture it in Alola?
When you capture or breed it.
Mm.
So a parent of an... of a regular... so the kid of a regular Exeggutor is an Alolan Exeggutor.
Okay. That must be complicated to program.
Honestly, there's so many little off cases and rules and stuff in Pokemon that yeah, it's probably just as well that you build incrementally, because... Comet Punch!
Comet Punch is good.
Another one. Yeah, there's a really long hike between gyms 1 and 2, and I really don't know why. Wait, she's got 3 of these?
Oh, probably 2 represent all of them.
Grass, sand, and insulation form. Building insulation form. Like, why?
Because it's pink and cute.
Fair enough. But it's like fiberglass. How does the bug survive?
Well, the bug survives from everything else.
Fair enough. Bonk.
Scizor, Fortress, and Steel Wormadam have the most obvious weakness, but it's their only weakness.
Yeah. I'm still looking forward to that normal ghost type, that where its only weakness is going to be dark someday. Please.
Oh, I was just like, there's a normal what? I don't...
There isn't one yet, but...
I was just like, what? That's not type null, is it? That type null is just pure normal.
No, I'm just hoping they make one, because of the type... Oh, something I've been wondering. What's your opinion on the final evolution of the starters?
Well, they haven't been officially released, so I don't know.
Oh, sorry, I mean the leak.
I don't really look at leaks,
That's actually probably a good policy.
If
the leak created some controversy.
Yeah, because some supposed leaks are not always leaks.
Fair enough.
Either way, I'm getting Rallet.
Fair enough.
Which Sun Moon starter are you interested in?
Well, I want Litten, but I don't want... the final form for Litten is a bit...
What's the typing? Dark Fire?
Yeah, but it's like a big...
Plus, I would think that would be amazingly hilarious.
I just traded for a cool new Pokemon. I feel kind of sorry for this kid. And by that, I mean I feel really sorry for this kid.
Well, maybe this kid will somehow get its 400 Magikarp candies and get to evolve.
That's true. Actually, in the original Ruby and Sapphire, they didn't do this in Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. There's a guy on Duford Island, and when you fight him, he has 6 Magikarps. But once they enable rematches in the game, you come back and he has 1 Magikarp, and then he has 5 Gyarados. It's a bit of a wake-up call, to say the least.
I recently did a Nuzlocke on the original Sapphire.
How was it?
I made it through. Almost lost my Wobbuffet, but I didn't.
Ah yes, Wobbuffet, otherwise known as the Pokemon that... Ooh, Bubble Beam. Let's see here. Ooh, nice. I'll just toss. Okay, Charm is double lowers attack stat. Tail Whip. I'll just toss Water Gun for that because Bubble will also lower speed and it's the same power. Okay.
This room was empty, even though it was supposed to be reserved for another group. That group left early, and I got here early, so it's for setting up. There were so many people who were giving me weird looks coming in.
What?
Because, I had this all set up, and I was kind of playing Harmonite while I was waiting. And, yeah, people gave me weird looks through the window. It's just why is she hogging the study room for games?
Pikachu! Thank you! Bye bye!
I once saw a post where someone had come up with the idea that every name in Dragon Ball was a pun. So, you have Vegeta and Bulma, so Vegeta Bull, something like that.
Yeah. I don't know about Goten. Don't know about Goten's naming pattern.
Oh my gosh, standing alongside your Pokemon in some moon is gonna be so good.
What's with these normal trainers having potions?
It's X and Y. You have potions and use them, why not?
Because I have money by beating those guys.
Maybe they have day jobs.
You can have a day job in Pokemon?
How do you think all those shopkeepers and Pokemon Center receptionists, Ooh, quick attack. And there's Pikachu.
Pika!
Suyotani.
Oh. Critical. Oof. Oof.
Oof. Oof. I don't know.
What? What?
I don't know. I just said a name.
Oh my gosh. Lots of XP.
Well, that's because Pikachus are cool, and so is Ralts.
What's Ralts' evolution level? It's like 16 or something.
I don't remember. I've raised two Ralts, but I don't remember. Oh, I see. It's registered in your Pokédex. That's what I would expect from one of the professor's word I can't see from here.
Handpicked.
Pokemon trainers.
Yeah, if you thought these guys stand out, just wait until the mysterious masked Avengers show up. The first time I actually played Pokemon X and Y, I ended up calling these two the Lutices after a certain other mysterious pair. Fortunately, these aren't as, messed up.
Okay, I will put a picture on the screen then. Flabébé is now, brace yourself, a fairy Pokémon!
Speaking of someone who's holding a Ralts in their bag, I kind of know that.
Fairy type is... Ba-da-da-da-da!
What?
Shut up, I'm talking! And wait for blah 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 blah! On Professor Sycamore's request, I'm... a person?
It's a beautiful name for a beautiful lady. Wait, what? I'm Dexio, and Sina always talks over me when I'm talking.
Because I'm more important!
You could call me a Pokemon Voyage veteran. Wait, why isn't he wearing an Ace Trainer getup then?
Mm-hmm.
Not yet.
Even though you got 13 minutes according to my timer.
Yeah, see, I tend to be a slow player because I just try and explore everywhere.
Sorry about the time limit. I wanted to book the room for longer, but,
If you want, we could move to somewhere else and continue.
Okay, I guess after this timer goes off. It'll be like a break.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure this is actually relevant for Azurill.
Azurill evolves by friendship. And I find it hilarious that it used to be if you had a female Azurill, there's a chance that it could turn into a male when evolving.
I mean, see? Gate attendant. Day job.
Maybe that's not her day job. Maybe she's volunteering in hopes of getting a Flabébé.
She could just go into the tall grass out there and catch one.
But what if she doesn't have any Pokeballs?
She can work at her day job to get money for a Pokeball. Remember, all the prices are in like Poké Yen, so divide by 100 to get dollars. So a Pokeball is a dollar, effectively. They're like super cheap.
And she's gonna go ahead. Yeah, it's just like...
They went that away, Padna.
One would think that in real life, Pokeballs would not be you wouldn't be able to get them at a dollar store.
Well, to be fair, they are just Pokeballs. The Great Balls and Ultra Balls cost more.
Well, yeah. But still, I would imagine with tech like that being a lot to produce.
It's like any other kind of tech. If you do it for a while, you know, they find ways to optimize the whole thing.
The professor wants you!
Floor door. I turned on the 3D, but the camera couldn't see it.
Mm, yeah. Fantastic! You're here! Come this way, won't you?
Hi there, me.
I don't know what voice that was. I think I was trying to do French, but it didn't turn out to be French.
Cool.
Well, that'll be convenient for catching.
Yeah.
I'm Professor Sycamore. It's a pleasure to finally meet you. How is your Pokémon journey going so far? Have you met many... Have you met many of them?
Okay, when you said finally meet you, I just couldn't help thinking of Kel'Thuzad at the final boss battle in the Naxxramas adventure in Hearthstone, except there it's an immortal evil skeleton that's trying to kill you.
Fantastic! I am a skeleton now!
Oh! I just created some really hecked up headcanon, didn't I?
Well...
What do you suppose je ne sais quoi means?
Je ne sais quoi. Have to ask my dad. He's fluent in French. I'm not.
Yeah, I don't know what either.
I have a good feeling about you. At first, I was thinking of choosing only one child from a town.
Oh, right. He sent along three Pokeballs.
Yep. Sent three Pokeballs. Shauna, Serena, and Claire. Pro.
Child of a veteran.
Mm-hmm. Yep, according to the last episode, apparently Crow is the child of Grace and Peter Pan.
What?
Yeah. Yeah. But of course that could change. I mean, the way this works, it's just like the lore is going to get really weird or convoluted. I assume.
It could be worse. I mean, Ash could look like his Alola.
He would look better if he was looked like the default protagonist. I mean, I'm not a fan of the new art style for the Sun Moon anime.
No one is. No one that I've talked to, anyway.
Now, when I first saw it, I was just like, this is a prank, right?
I honestly think Korokoro was... the artist was having an off day.
Mm. That won't affect Hina's... Gust? No. Favorite Gen 1 combo, Leech Seed and Poison Powder. No, Leech Seed and Toxic, that was it. Actually, one time when I was on Miiverse, I felt very proud of myself. I was on the Pokemon Red, Blue, Yellow forum post, mm-hmm. and someone was asking where the last gym leader was. And I was just like, it's from Viridian City, in Japanese. I was able to read their question and write the answer in Japanese and felt so proud of that.
Wait, they asked in Japanese?
Yeah, they asked in Japanese.
Amazing.
I mean, granted, I had to look up the name of Viridian City in Japanese, but...
That's fair. One of the abilities in Japanese, I think it's simple. Bulbapedia gives a literal translation of the name, of the Japanese name as well, and it translates as, doofus.
Okay. Now, I still don't know what simple does.
If a Pokemon gets a stat stage boost or drop, it doubles it.
Oh, okay. Sounds like something Misty Psyduck would do.
No, wait. That is simple, right? Yeah, that's simple.
Any plans for your Bulbasaur name? Or was it Squirtle? Is Squirtle your day product?
Squirtle, yeah. Honestly, I probably should think of that. Uh-oh.
That wasn't bad.
Yeah. Could be worse. I mean, you know, Mega Lucario used...
What's his name can survive another one? Maybe?
That shouldn't come up. Wow. You've seen Pokemon Origins, right?
Yes.
That scene at the end with Mewtwo and Mega Charizard X. Whap. What?
That's Smokeswing?
Yeah.
Okay. That would... Yeah, Mega Charizard X was obviously put in there for an ad with X and Y.
Yeah, but... Still, just... You know, it Mega Evolves and then it's able to face up to Mewtwo. It's just, like, really epic, right? You know?
Mm-hmm.
Also, you know, there's the whole bit where Red throws an Ultra Ball and it shakes, and then the Ultra Ball literally explodes as Mewtwo busts out. It's...
Origins is great. And I like that how...
Oh, right. Generations is coming out.
It's already out.
Has come out. Oh, dear. I need to watch it.
There's only 2 episodes right now. The second one is, oh my gosh, so great. And when I showed it to my dad and brother, because they also like Pokemon, it was just like, my brother said to me, he's just like, nope, this only proves my point even further. The anime would be good if Ash wasn't in it.
Okay, let's see. Noble Roar lowers the target's attack and SP attack stats, so I'll remove Leer because Workup substitutes for an equivalent of that.
Mm.
Noble Woof.
My, I don't know what I'm saying. You won.
I got $14.
What a stingy professor.
No, it's like all he had on his wallet. Half of. Here we go.
Take one of my Pokemon from me. I don't think that counts as playing a song.
Okay, who are we gonna send out? Oh.
What?
Sorry, Kirie is actually getting good at her job.
Oh. Okay.
It's just I like Azumarill.
Mmm.
Right.
Well, you can always get her back out.
Oh my gosh, it's a female squad!
Holy crow! And what is it named? I assume it's not what's her name.
No. Liliane with a tilde.
Okay. Is that just because it's a nice name, or is it from something?
Blah.
I don't know if I can put up a picture of blah.
See, it's sort of an in-joke. The in-joke was that the first name that came to mind was completely inappropriate and was called and so I adapted that for something that sounded more like someone who would be swimming, so to make it sound a bit it's more fluid, right? And, you know, I guess you could put up a picture of a cool character named Lilith.
All right. So, technically speaking, I have the room for 8 more minutes, but no one has come to kick us out, so...
Okay. The secret and potential of Mega Evolution. Oh, Mega Rayquaza can hold a Zed crystal.
It can hold 2 items?
Mega Rayquaza doesn't need a Megastone to evolve because it's, it, like, swallowed the meteor that powers it, and all it needs is your, fervent wish in Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, so it can hold an item on top of that.
Sounds cheap.
Smogon, which is famous for classifying Pokemon into tiers, invented its very own tier for Mega Rayquaza named Anything Goes, above even Ultra Rare or whatever their top tier is. Legend used or super overused or... Fuck, I don't remember.
The only thing I know about competitive Pokemon is that in 2015... It was either 2015 or 2014 that someone won the Worlds with the Pachirisu in his party.
That'd be Seijun, and that was 2014, I think? And he had a Mega Gyarados.
But he had a Pachirisu, which is amazing! Oh, when did they all get there?
When you weren't looking.
Alright. So since Squirtle's not counted, you still have 2 more captures on you.
Oh my. Makes me want to go out and... Villain alert! Villain alert!
So, I will be able to meet them soon, then. Yes!
Yes!
The children chosen by the professor. I wonder what potential they have.
Villain alert!
And here's one now! That's Crow! Crow! Crow, get here!
Who named this guy, anyway?
I did.
High five.
Named after the Ruby character, if you watch that.
The Twitch Plays Pokemon character? Was there one?
Not TPP, Rooster Teeth.
Ooh. By the way, this is going to sound like weird conspiracy theorizing, but are you familiar with the...
Okay, let's hope the library didn't hear that. Or else we could be kicked out.
There's a reason these rooms have soundproofing.
Crow! Bye-bye! There's something I need to do. Bye.
She said she wanted to actually meet and talk about something.
Campfire Town.
Campfire Town.
I'm pretty sure the inmates pronounce campfire.
Probably. I'm deliberately mispronouncing it.
Oh, okay.
Honestly, I'd feel a lot better about the power outage excuse if they actually blacked out that part of town at night.
Oh, yeah? Yeah. I remember,
Oh, hey.
A lot of the times I ended up playing at night, so I would go there and I was just like, what are you doing? All right.
Let's be honest here. When I had Pokemon X and Y, I had a little problem where I spent all my money on clothes and hair.
It's already medium.
Oh. And then I didn't have any money for Pokeballs. Oh man, wait until we meet AZ. F***ing! I want a do-over! Speak for yourself, lady.
Well, spending the money isn't my problem.
Okay, so...
Unless you're tagging me in. Who are you tagging?
I don't know. I could. Do you want to?
It's your choice. I mean, you could tag me, you could tag someone I don't know, you could tag Andrew because he's just like... I read his comment on the last video and he wants to be tagged in and I'm just like, that's not my choice!
Okay, so basically, see how we have had a Nuzlocke run up to this point? Mm-hmm. Well, what I just got is a Nuzcut.
Yeah. Blend in with his hair.
Or I suppose you could call it a JoJo's Bizarre Adventure cut. Andrew will know exactly what I'm talking about when he watches this.
Oh, it's Lysander. Just so you know, neighbor, Lysander is the head of
As
Lysander
you know.
Labs. And he has hurt Z2 or whatever. Oh, is she still talking?
Yeah.
Okay. You played a young girl very well, Diantha. What a strange thing.
Basically, he's asking her about... Is this X or Y?
This is X.
He's asking her about eternal youth, so...
Yes, don't you want to stay pretty for the rest of your life? Blah, blah, blah. I don't know what I'm saying.
Villain alert!
In the... Do you know the character Alon from the anime?
Which one?
The one who dresses like Mega Charizard X.
So, like, every Poke cosplayer from here to... From here to Anvil... From here to... To... I can't remember the names of the cities anymore. Okay, who?
Okay, so... He dresses like Mega Charizard X, and... He works for, like, he was the protagonist of the Mega Evolution X, and he works for Lysander, and I was just like, why? Why? I was cheering for you!
You know why? Dramatic twist. I'm a trainer myself in my off time. I look forward to us battling someday.
Foreshadow.
Oh my god, that is one of those one-liners that eventually comes back to bite you square in the ass.
I actually thought she was a really easy champion.
Honestly, yeah. I it would have been nice if the Elite Four had had Mega Evolutions.
Yeah. I guess. We're gonna have to. Alright.
Let me save the thing. Oh, geez. Rival battle.
She's not rival battling.
just found out we're back for like half an hour or so, so that Ben can get his two remaining Pokemon. And yeah. So are you keeping
Probably. Okay, right. So she doesn't want a rival battle immediately. That's good because
the Pokemon you're dealing with something?
No, I was gonna train them on. I was gonna battle every trainer on Route 4.
Ah, I see. Personally, just giving you my own personal advice, I'd get my Pokemon first before going to train, just so that
you don't have to worry
about the time running out.
That's true.
So you have two more captures, since Squirtle did not count.
Maybe I can catch a Smeargle.
That'd be cool. Oh, news time! Or, no, Tierno time! Called it! I'm on Route 5! Come see me!
Ba-dum! Oh man. You remember Connecting Cave, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, I get my first Horde battle that I've ever played in the game, you know?
Hey! Yep.
And it's in Connecting Cave, which means
Zubat.
Horde of Zubat.
Also called Zubat Roost, if I remember correct.
Oh, yeah. It's just like, you know. Oh, you know what would be funny?
What's that?
If Alolan Zubat were, like, really badass and not annoying.
Make it like a fire or ice piece?
Something. Speaking of which,
what do Talk About Zelda enemies make you think of?
Well, you said I thought you said chocolate Zelda enemies just now, and now I'm hungry.
Oh, okay.
Woof!
Wait, Luke, how are you?
Oh, wait, this is that battle, isn't it?
No, it's not that battle. That battle happens, leaving General Siege, I think it's called. See, Lucario likes you. This Lucario's been with me. It's ran away. Oops, my name's Karina. I'm the Shalor City Gym. I give out badges. See you later. Come on, Lucario.
Woof, woof.
It's kind of an abridge of what she's doing.
Oh. Skate park!
I assume you, I just assume you haven't watched the XY anime, right?
No, I have not, in point of fact.
Pikachu was reunited with Ketchup.
Ketchup?
Do you, did you see the episode of the original series of the Scyther Gym versus the, I think it was the,
I haven't really watched the anime much.
Okay, well, there's an episode where there's these two dojos fighting against each other, and Pikachu falls in love with Ketchup. And it's like, it's eating all this ketchup, licking the bottle, putting, drowning Ash's food in ketchup. But then Scyther slices the ketchup bottle and breaks Pikachu's heart. So in X and Y, like 20 years later, Pikachu is reunited with Ketchup.
You know what? I'm calling it now. Oh, weirdest Alolan Pokemon, Ketchup Bottle Pokemon.
I would honestly love a Ketchup Pokemon. I'd be like, I would nickname it something like Pikachu's Heart.
I'm gonna swap out my team.
Okay. Not gonna catch something first, just in case there's something good,
I forgot about that. Oh wait, no, it's. I think I want to go to the yellow flowers up there.
Oh, okay. Oh, that haircut. Since apparently I'm tagging him next time, I'm dyeing his hair just so that people know. Because I want to be able to see that hat. You can't see it with that thing. It's hard enough when you add medium hair. After gym battles, I do training montages where I train every single Pokemon to at least the same level as the gym leader. Strongest, including the ones in the box. Took me 3 hours last time.
That's good.
Just so that people can have a variety.
Thank you for your hard work.
thank you for being on the show.
Oh man, the original double team.
Kirie, mine!
Yep.
My mind undied in mine when I was long. And this was in my Staffire Nuzlocke, where Minon's just like a 1% chance of finding.
Growl too strong.
Just looking at Electric Rotom mascots, what do you think of Togedemaru and Mimikyu, even though Mimikyu is not technically the mascot?
Mimikyu is going to be weird, depending on how many sprites they give it. I honestly hope that it's got, like, sprites for every single one, but I doubt it.
Oh, Mimikyu? It only has, like, Pikachu. That's the only napkin it wears.
I was kind of looking forward to it wearing, like, a... Okay.
Mimikyu wears Pikachu because it is a lonely Pokemon, and Pikachu has a huge rise in popularity with Pikachu toys being sold. So in order to try and get a trainer of its own, it disguises as Pikachu.
That's fair. It's pretty cool, actually.
Yeah, my friend was telling me that Mimikyu might be one of her, like, her son's, one of her son's favorite Pokemon.
Now, Togedemaru, electric steel type, oh my gosh.
Personally, I think even though Togedemaru is technically the Gen 7 electric mascot, it's definitely going to be outshined by Mimikyu, in my opinion. Just because Mimikyu literally looks like Pikachu.
Mm-hmm. Roll.
Rock and roll all night.
Ooh, Leech Seed. We have Bite, Growl, Vine Whip, and Rollout. Okay, I'll toss Growl.
One of the things I love about this is it's longer, and because there are various people, I get to do so many reference edits, putting in, like...
Thank you, Andrew.
Oh, okay. There you go, Andrew.
Alright, oh dear. Let's see if I can...
This is a tag battle.
Swords Dance.
Oh, no, it's a double battle. I thought this was the tag battle.
I think
it's not even a tag. Which battle am I thinking of? I know something like that happens on this route.
Something core fishy.
There is definitely something core fishy about this.
Oh, cool. It knows withdraw.
Squirtle's so cute. My yellow Nuzlocke, Squirtle and Pikachu were the only starters that survived to the end. My Charmeleon got blown up.
Yeah, I don't want to talk about my black and white Nuzlocke. That globally did not end well.
Hmm. Oh, just,
It ended well eventually, because I caught a Cobalion.
Oh, Cobalion, yeah.
But...
Oh, so you used legendaries in your Nuzlocke?
It basically, you've played Black and White, right?
Yeah.
Level 54 Hydreigon.
I got a level 64 Hydreigon via Wonder Trade. I felt so guilty after that because I sent off a level 15 Flabébé. But yeah. It is a high level thing.
But yeah, like, and Getsis' Chidi Hydreigon is basically something I knew that I'd have to, so I didn't catch anything in Viridian Forest?
Don't you mean Pinwheel Forest?
In Pinwheel Forest, Inner, because Inner is a separate area, so that I could catch, Cobalion.
I was devastated when this happened, but I found it probably the most hilarious thing that's happened to me in a Nuzlocke, in which I was racing an Electrode, and it fainted because of a Clefairy's metronome. The reason why metronome turned into explosion.
Ah, yes. They do that.
How ironic is that? So, Electrode died from explosion, but it didn't explode. I miss my cucumber.
Bubble is 40, water gun is 40. Okay, so it has a chance to lower speed, so we will swap.
The bubble team!
Ba-ba-da, 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 you beat me!
With your nose cut!
Wait, you set the nickname the same as the...
Yeah.
Yeah, fair enough. Yeah, I'm told that the Pokemon programmers neglected to take into mind some of the unfortunate possibilities created by the nickname system. Most of them involve a male character for some reason.
Oh.
Like I said, unfortunate possibilities.
Okay. Based off the default nicknames?
Yep. Okay. Like... You get the idea.
There's a on the two choice Pokemon characters. Did you watch the play of Pokemon X by Twitch or participate?
Not really. I was only around for the first two. I think I might have stopped in briefly, but oh geez, this is getting a little dire.
In that one, people were saying that their they chose the white male, but they were saying that this character must actually be female because their name is.
There we go. Okay, so tall grass. Oh, cool.
That's cute. Female Panchamp, so that'll be catch number two. Panchamp.
Hopefully.
Oh, that Panchamp was already part dark. There you go. Now, are you going to count that, or are we not counting it?
I'm counting it.
Okay, so Panchamp ran away with a Pokeball this wall.
That's what you get when you have lots of students with pencils.
Janitor must hate this room.
Well, obviously they just ignore it, because the graffiti's still on the wall.
But how old is each graffiti? That's the question. Like, is there one here from 1956?
This building didn't exist in 1956. It was only opened 10 years ago.
Oh. Well, is there one that's 10 years old?
I don't recall leaving one at that age, so possibly not.
So I would think that during summer the janitor would have to clean up these walls. That's my assumption.
Actually, you're probably actually right.
So are we getting this or not? Because I don't know how far you can get in 4 minutes.
Yeah, why not? That's the other thing. This is... Oh, it's a male. Aww.
I think that's fine enough.
If it was female, I was gonna make a reference, a Danganronpa reference to Coco.
Oh. Okay. That's male.
So instead, I'll make a reference to.
What, you don't know?
I was having trouble remembering his name for a second.
Oh, I see.
It's a character from Ace Attorney 6.
Yondo Tornado.
Yes, that's his name. It's from the case.
I don't have Ace Attorney 6 yet.
Yes, but you will have it sometime in the future, and then you'll know why I named it Doduo.
Okay, but I gotta slap a picture up on it.
You could Google images it and try and just get the image without getting the spoilers.
Alright, let's hope Google will do that.
It's a g-
Oh well, I'll just assume that the first picture is there and I'll close my eyes to all the others.
I can find the picture if you want, like just give you the image URL.
Oh, that's fine. That's fine, I'm complaining for nothing. So, I think after this battle, then time's up.
Alright. But yeah, this was fun. Bit by bit, we'll get there someday.
Oh! Huh. I think... Well, I'll say this when I do my episode.
Ugh.
Did we almost lose Trunks? Oh, no, we didn't.
The next one probably would. Give me a minute while I check something. Multiple somethings. Okay, that'll work.
Go Fire Emblem Reference!
Dang, if only he was one level higher. He'll get one level out of this battle, though, so...
Okay. Do it, Eliwood! I think you're one of the immortal characters in your game! Please be immortal here. Oh, dang it.
Oh.
Hmm.
As long as I can land one hit, we're good.
Well. Good. Eliwood just loves those spoons.
Don't
hit yourself, Eliwood! Eliwood is the only male of this team. He has his own little weird harem.
Shit! Sorry about this. I really am.
Eliwood.
I should have chosen Bulbasaur.
Bulbasaur wouldn't have done good with this.
No, but he'd be a replacement.
Mm. Alright. Well, I guess we got better go... kill off... Well, he's already killed off. Go... Let's see. Well, Eliwood, you were a good Pokemon. And now you're dead. So, oops.
I'll swap a window in for now. Or, yeah. No,
You have your stylus right there, you know.
I know.
Alright, folks.
Yeah. Well.
Thank you for watching.
Thank you for watching.